Hello out there, world. My name's Chris, and I'm retired quarantining for you. Quarantine does funny things to a man. I was passed out on the couch most of yesterday. Apparently, Canadian Chris took over, grabbed the camera, and posted a video. So my apologies to anyone who that might have offended. But, I mean, truth be told, if you're going to do a video to teach people about some of the Canadian funny lingo, I don't think there's a better guy to do it than Canadian Chris. So as upset as I was at him hijacking the channel, I will say I watched the video and I'm happy that he decided to use some of this quarantine time to teach my viewers a little bit more about my homeland. Yes, this is a channel all about Thailand, and yes, I'm not even out of quarantine and I can't wait to get back to Thailand. But today's video is part two of this quarantine series where I'm gonna teach you a little more about Canada. And today's video's all about Canadian hip hop, the whole Canadian rap scene and the history of it. I'm gonna walk you through just six different artists that each represent a different era in Canadian rap music. The last ones are, one guy's the biggest selling global artist, I think, of all time, at least as it pertains to downloads. We'll get to that. But to tell the story of Canadian hip hop, we gotta go right back to the beginning. The year was 1989, and rap music had already hit the mainstream and the big time in the US, but it was virtually non-existent up here in Canada at the time, and there was nobody having commercial success. But that all changed when one man named Maestro Fresh West dropped a tune that I bet every single Canadian out there remembers.
This is a throwdown, a showdown. Hell no, I can't slow down. It's gonna go.
First offense.
All of the mix.
It's called Let Your Backbone Slide. And this tune literally changed the course of Canadian rap music forever.
Okay, party people in the house.
May I have your attention, please?
In a moment, the beat will be played in many parts.
I'm just a big Guess Who fan, and I remember being a kid hearing These Eyes, and it just resonated with me. And if I could just put these words together and talk about people's, what we see in our vision and what we do, and it's okay to fall, cause you're going to get back up.
I remember sitting in my parents' basement with my buddies. We were still just in high school, and this tune dropped, and it was like nothing we'd ever heard come out of Canada before. It was awesome.
Check out my whole boy dance to the rhythm. Hey, this ain't Forte. Hey, I'm coming double F, Fortissimo, F for Funky Fresh. My DJ is LTD, Mellow Flex. You listen to the poetry, pitch, I project. Vocabulary golden, beats from my rolling. Stone cold lyrics with the microphone I'm holding. Words are ripped, egos are stripped. I make sucker crews kick, take Van Dyke flips. I get busy, they're dizzy, they start to collide. They should have stepped off. I let it slide, but now they got brazen. Dry like a raisin, I glaze like a vase. I smack shellac days until they realize they shouldn't have ripped. It's 89, y'all, not Beethoven's fifth or sixth. It's a throwdown, I'm conducting it. The cars are high rise, I'm constructing it. 'Twas once a thought, pen and paper. Now it's a tower, a solar skyscraper. Let's get it out of hand, I created a monster. A musical monologue makes you wanna move with the maestro. You feel high, so it's set. The blend, the crescendo is nice, yo. I'm the guy, the rhythm is a ride. Rhythm is a ride to the fresh side and let your backbone slide.
That's Maestro Fresh West, who now officially holds the title of the godfather of Canadian rap. If you want to skip ahead, there's going to be six songs played. Just take a look in the video description, and I'll put timestamps and chapters for each new artist. So if Maestro's the godfather, well, the godmother has to be artist number two in today's list.
The hardest thing in the game for me in coming up was I was a woman. I was an immigrant from Jamaica. I was a woman, and it was hip-hop. It was a man's world.
Her name is Mishi Me. She burst onto the Toronto rap scene and really flexed her Caribbean roots.
Bringing that West Indian culture to that hip-hop and letting them know that, you know, there's a lot of diversity in the music here, and we want to bring it to rap music, so we hung on to that.
Toronto's always had this amazing and deep connection to the Caribbean. In fact, the Caribana Festival that happens here every summer is absolutely massive and one of the biggest in the world.
Look how the sun now raising up, and the crowd now waking up. The atmosphere have vibes, and nothing can break it up. The girl them a wine non-stop, we had the drinks them in a mic up. We're gonna party all night, all night.
And so when Mishi Me started to bring that flavor and put it into Toronto rap, she really pioneered the female voice of Canadian rap.
Good, baby.
So just push up your one if you are Jamaican man. You know your back, you can't take the sun long. All is okay, you are article done. Jamaica woman, you have to be alone for the walk. Do your Jamaican sweet girl bikini. Them the girls say that them have the winery. What make the man them a run after she? You never know what says she a yardie. Men travel for miles around, they know what's in town. Jamaican.
So Maestro and Mishi defined the old school, and as the 90s began to wind down, one of the first of what I'll call the new wave of rappers appeared in Toronto.
My parents, we moved to Trinidad, and I came back roughly around grade 8, end of grade 8. I sort of tried to assimilate back into this whole kind of environment. I don't know how many people are watching came from this culture, but why not embrace it and make that part of the music? And not gravitate to the pain, because sometimes pain is easy to express over music. It's not necessarily because they just want to exploit, but sometimes a painful song or a song about struggle sort of resonates with people more than talking about coming from 190 Michael Boulevard and having two parents who, you know, were in love.
Because it's normal.
Yeah, because it's nuclear family, right? And it's like, when was that ever really cool to rock and roll?
And he was the perfect bridge between the old school and the new school, with the intelligent lyrics and really musical and funky beats. He was kind of Canada's version of A Tribe Called Quest or De La Soul. His name was Chaos, and one of his big tunes went a little like this.
Yeah, it's a conniption fit in the microphone. Take it higher like a bird on a wire, retire the fire, I'll never, cause I'm just moving on up, choosing to touch the unseen, craving the clutch, the most inevitable, legible pyromania, slaying the devil and sending them back to Transylvania. Strangely enough, I evolved outside of the ghetto, but my heavy metal will settle the puppets like Geppetto. Damn, if mirrors were created by sand, then I'm looking in the water for reflections of man. Understand, the mind's above time when it's empty, MC, tragically hip ahead by a century.
I'm trying to get down, cause I'm moving. No time to get down, cause I'm moving up. No time to get down, cause I'm moving up. Shake off the crabs in the bucket. No time to get down, cause I'm moving up. No time to get down, cause I'm moving up. No time to get down, cause I'm moving up. Shake off the crabs in the bucket.
As the century changed and we ran into the 2000s, it started to actually become cool for a rapper to say they're from Toronto. But there was one rapper who I give a ton of credit for anyway, who always made his hometown a major character in all his music.
For me, I think reinvention and creativity is so key and vital to longevity.
Yeah, we don't say you know what I'm saying, T-Dot says you don't know. We don't say, hey, that's the breaks, we say, yo, so it go. We don't say you get one chance, we say you better rip the show before bottles stop flying and you running for the dough. We talk about cutting and hitting skins, we talk about beat that face. See that to eat your food before y'all cats say grace. Your cats are steady saying word, my cats are steady yelling. Half the time we talking about more times, we don't even know what more times means. More times we rock pressure, more times we come correct. More times y'all think it's the hot. Haven't heard nothing yet. Differently, still, you know? The circle getting ill, you know. Step on the wrong ballet booth, you might get glitch, you know. So every time you walk through the dance, tell her yo, excuse me. Telling the Jubilee I like her style, she's talking about abuse me, use me. Show me how to tee down rolls. My style's off the thermostat. Plus I'm coming from the cold. Yeah.
I mean, he even made a song called The Anthem.
Region, jungle, Vaughn Road, Malvern, yeah. Chester Lee, Rexdale, let the fire burn. Yeah. John Garland, Flemo, stand up. If you from Toronto, let me see you put a hand up. Born alone, die alone, but I'm never on my own. No watch, no face, stay true is what I was shown. I'm a product of OGs and social workers. 3 years of university and Licks Burgers. Harlem Underground, black-owned businesses. Bigot up hats and immigrants from long distances. Working class people and some others with some privileges. Anywhere you look at it, we're seeing past differences. Yo, I am multicultural. Hand to my ear, listening like the holster. And all I'm hearing is we the greatest around. To the grave, I'ma rep my town. Yeah,
I'm from the Queen.
Repping everywhere I go. Everybody from the cold. This is where we call it home.
With the foundation now laid by Maestro Fresh West, Mishy Me, continued on by Chaos and Cardinal, now it was time for a global takeover, and it started a little bit like this.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here, nigga. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team fucking here. I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month, nigga. I was tryna get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way home. And my uncle calling me like, where you at? I gave you the keys, so you bring it right back, nigga. I just think it's funny how it goes. Now I'm on the road, half a million for a show. And
started from the bottom, now we're here.
As we started to rise, the biggest thing and the most important thing was that everyone else got to see that it was possible. Because at the time, the pitch was far-fetched. Like, okay, so you're telling me this Canadian Jew child actor is gonna be what? The realization that it's possible was extremely important. I don't credit myself for anything other than that.
Fuck a fake friend, where your real friends at? We don't like to do too much explaining. Story stay the same through the money and the fame. Cause we started from the bottom, now we're here.
So now we're present day. Canadian artists are super comfortable in their own skin. And they began dropping tunes that were winning Grammys, topping the pop charts, and really defining the music industry and culture, not just in Canada, but in the epicenter of the entertainment industry.
Your man on the road, he doing promo. You say keep our business on the low low. I'm just trying to get you out the friend zone. Cause you look even better than the photos. I can't find your house, send me the info. Driving through the gated residential. Found out I was coming, sent your friends home. Keep on trying to hide it, but your friends know.
I only call you when it's half past. By the only time that I be by your side. I only love it when you touch me. Now feel me when I'm fucked up. That's a real me when I'm fucked up. That's a real me, yeah.
So there you have it, a brief history of Canadian hip-hop told in six artists with six different clips. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely appreciate you guys watching it. I got 5 days left in quarantine here, and I just can't wait to get out and, first of all, go see a bunch of people, friends and family that I'm dying to see, and secondly, make some videos and show you guys a little bit more Canada than this balcony. But in the meantime, again, I appreciate you guys watching. I think I might do one of these on Canadian rock music tomorrow, but drop a comment, let me know. Do you just want me to stop making videos while I'm in quarantine, or do you want to see another one like this? Anyways, let me know in the comments. Hope you guys are doing good. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.
Coo 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 coo. Coo, loo, coo, 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 coo.